My name is David Madden. I'm a director at IFAC, where I develop and coordinate our policy on advocacy and sustainability. At IFAC, we believe that the accountancy profession has an important role to play in enabling the sustainable transition. One aspect of this role is to bring trust and confidence to the sustainability information that companies report through high-quality assurance, just like we do for financial reporting. That's why IFAC and AICPA CIMA have been working together to conduct benchmarking research on the state of play in sustainability assurance and its reporting around the world. Our first research report was published in June of 2021. This year, we will update our findings based on fiscal 2020 company disclosures, and we anticipate expanding this project further with data from 2021. In order to identify year-over-year trends, our research this year again examined information from 1,400 companies in the G20 countries plus Singapore and Hong Kong SAR. We continue to find a lot of ESG reporting. Around 90% of companies are reporting some ESG information. However, the incidence of assurance of this information is still lagging. But there was an increase to 58% in the number of companies who also obtained assurance over some portion of what they reported. Most assurance, still over 80%, is limited, not reasonable in nature. Audit firms are doing the majority of ESG assurance engagements, just over 60%. But that means over a third of engagements are being done outside the accountancy profession. When accounting firms are engaged, they are overwhelmingly using assurance standards issued by the International Auditing and Assurance Standards Board, or IAASB. Finally, we continue to find big differences in the results between jurisdictions. Let's quickly review how ESG information is being reported by companies. Of 1,283 companies who did report ESG information, most still provide that information in standalone corporate sustainability reports. But we did observe in the 2020 data that some companies are transitioning to integrated reports or annual reports. We also observed a rather dramatic increase, a doubling, of reporting with reference or use of SASB standards as well as the TCFD framework. This is important given the role that SASB and TCFD will play in the work of the International Sustainability Standards Board, or ISSB. Finally, GRI and the SDGs remain the most frequently used standard or framework, when we must keep in mind that this reporting is intended for multi-stakeholder, societal impact-focused reporting. The focus of the new ISSB will be a global baseline of investor-focused disclosures. Perhaps the most important finding from our analysis of ESG reporting is that most companies use multiple standards rather than any single standard or framework. In fact, in 2020, 80% of companies, that's up from 68% in the prior year, were relying on more than one set of standards for their ESG reporting. IFAC's view is that the use of multiple standards, predominantly on a voluntary basis, is a barrier to consistent, comparable, and reliable information. And yet, consistent reporting is the best foundation for high-quality assurance. So current ESG reporting practice does not support the quality of ESG information we want, nor the quality and consistency of assurance that our profession wants to deliver. This is why the work of the new ISSB is so important. Now, shifting our focus to assurance. I've already noted the increase from 51% to 58%, with the biggest increases in Australia, Brazil, Italy, and the UK. Of the 833 assurance reports we found, 505 of them, or 61%, resulted from engagements conducted by audit firms. But there are big differences here between jurisdictions. For example, in France, audit firms have close to 100% market share. But there are six cases where most insurance is provided by consultants: the US, UK, Hong Kong SAR, India, Indonesia, and South Korea. While the IAASB's standard ISAE 3000 revised is the dominant standard, it's used 72% of the time, We saw a slight increase in the number of engagements conducted by consultants, and that resulted in more references to non-IAASB standards. This manifests itself in different levels of assurance being provided. When firms do assurance using ISAE 3000, 97% of those engagements result in limited opinions. When consultants are engaged, 59% of engagements result in limited opinions, but 23% are moderate and 18% are reasonable. Once we published our report last year, we conducted extensive engagement around the world to better understand jurisdictional practices. In December 2021, we published IFAC's vision for high-quality assurance of sustainability information. It's based on two things: the emerging best practices that we observed in the market, and it's predicated on high-quality global standards. I would like to conclude this introduction to our work on the reporting and assurance of sustainability information by urging you to take a closer look at our one-page vision recommendations, and by encouraging you to reach out and continue to engage with IFAC as we continue our policy work in this important area. Thank you.